and welcome back or welcome to my channel. My name is Taylor and today we'll be reacting to Kesha's new album, Gag Order. But before we hop into the video, remember to like, comment, and subscribe if you like all things music. I don't know about you, but before the month of May, I did not know Kesha was coming out with a new album, was not on my radar until I saw that she dropped two new singles. But when I listened to Fine Line and Eat the Acid, I was just not that impressed, not that excited. But if you saw my last video, which will be my Catch Up Friday video, I reacted to her single that led the actual album release date, Only Love Can Save Us Now, and I was highly impressed and really excited to see where everything went from there. So yeah, today we are going to be reacting to Gag Order by Kesha. It's got 13 tracks on the album. I've already listened to three, so we will not be reacting to Eat the Acid, Fine Line, or Only Love Can Save Us Now. But based on the track list, let's see what titles we're working with. I saw one of my friends, the people that I follow, post that Hate Me Harder was like the song that they listen to the most, and that's the one that Spotify recommended to me to listen to again, or listen to this week. So we're gonna look out for that one. But yeah, based off of what I've heard so far, there's going to be a lot of religious, like, take us to church moments. There's going to be a lot of old Kesha mixed with, like, a new, I don't know, I was going to say aggressive Kesha, but I don't know if that's the word. But yeah, let's hop into the reaction, starting with track one, Something to Believe In. Just remember that due to copyright, I will probably speed up most of the song clips that you hear in the video. Okay, there was a very like long like build of the intro there. I was like concerned that like Spotify just was not playing for a hot second, but just from what I've heard here and what I've heard from the other singles, she's definitely giving this like very like, I'm trying to describe it. It definitely is a more slow, like a lot of these first songs I imagine are just gonna be a more slow like build. I don't know how to best describe it, but it's darker in tone, slower in just like speed and stuff like that. So that's the vibe I'm getting. And Only Love Can Save Us Now, we know that goes differently. So, but yeah, this leads into Eat the Acid, which I've heard that song, so it makes sense stylistically. Okay, I'm gonna stop it there because I have a feeling this is gonna do what Only Love Can Save Us Now did, and that we're really just gonna get like one or two verses and just the chorus for the majority of the song. But yeah, definitely this is matching from what I've heard from everything else. It's definitely talking about how you don't know that you need something to believe in, or you don't know that you need a religion or a religious figure or an idol or something to bring you back to life until something happens. So that definitely sets up the vibe and the tone of the lyrics for the rest of the album. Well, that was an outro. Like, I'm so used to abandoning myself. Well, that's a choice. I was thinking while I was listening to the end of that, this sonically, which just like touching on it, kind of reminds me of Halsey's last project, If I Can't Have Love, I Want Power. So that's kind of getting the vibes. But that was a good song. Eat the Acid's next. I've already listened to that one. So track three, Living in My Head, is the next one we'll listen to. Do we think this is going to be more of an acoustic-y number? I feel like it's gonna drop into some like heavier production, but I'd be interested because I don't think I've heard a real acoustic-y number from Kesha in a hot second. I don't wanna be scared anymore. So scared of myself here anymore. Scared of everyone else anymore. I can already tell that I don't think this is gonna be my favorite song on the album, but I guess we'll have to hear. I mean, it is a more acoustic-y number. I will say I don't know if this is just something new. But the enunciation, I don't know, Which, granted, I already know my hearing is bad when, especially upon first listen, which I can't be complaining because we all love the Jonas Brothers and we know Nick Jonas can enunciate Worth Life, but the enunciation just seems a little more mumbled in some of her songs recently. So that could be just be like, that could be a me thing, that could be just something that is new with the acoustic-y part to this song. Don't know. So like I said, this is not a song that I'm really going to vibe with. I think it just is the production. I mean, not that I don't like more acoustic-y songs, but I think it's just the production. Which makes sense, because the following track is track 4, Fine Line, and that is the one of her first singles, and I did not vibe with that song at all. And then, of course, track 5, Only Love Can Save Us Now. If you watched my last video, you know that I was blown away by this song, and you know the production is just dun-dun-dun on that song, and I loved it. But up next, the next track we'll be listening to anyways is track 6, All I Need Is You. I'm hoping love song, or maybe this is another religious song, or maybe it's a familiar song. I don't know. Let's listen.
Take love is beyond your control.
Okay, another voice sampling. Authentic love is beyond your control. Well, I think this is going to be a love song.
And the most basic thing which is dangerous in you is the possibility of love.
Does anyone know where that's from? Leave it in the comments down below if you know where that's coming from, or if that's like some friend that she got to put that on the track.
Your love will break my heart harder than me and I'm alone. Oh, I'm flying through the galaxy, your hands always in mine. All my dreams have come and gone a half a million times. I don't need much, but there's one thing I can lose. All I
Okay, I'm in my feels with the lyrics on this song. Again, it's another slower song. We know those are not usually my jam, but the opening had me there. I think it'll build. I'm thinking it's gonna build, but I'm like, I can feel the misty eyes coming on, so. Again, I think I like this one more than Living in My Head, but again, the slower production, not always my thing, but the lyrics had me feeling my feels, and I appreciate the intro that we got and the little ooh, I don't know what I was doing there, but you know, just the little vocal elements that we got near the beginning and the end, those were pretty. But up next, I think we have the longest track on the album, and it's called The Drama, and it's explicit. And if this is anything like Only Love Can Save Us Now, I just am expecting bold statements and big things. So.
I crawl in pain, close my eyes, but I never can sleep. There's a plan.
Okay, but before we go any further, whoo, what is that? I don't know what that is. Synth? Something? Oh my god, the depth and the darkness of that has me hyped for what this song's gonna bring. What is this musical switch up we are having here? I'm so intrigued. So we get the gist of it. It's the drama of it all. So I guess, again, not really paying too much to the lyrics because the production has me going up and down and what's going on in my head. But the drama of it all. So obviously she's just kind of commenting on the drama of, I guess, her mind, the world around her. Okay, the production. The production is taking many like tricks and turns here, and I don't know how I feel about that, because I guess there's just a little bit of levity that they added into the song when they like flip things there at the beginning, which, you know, I pointed out. And I think I kind of would prefer this if it was a much darker, like, bass, like, in that dark tone. Maybe that's just me expecting like just a depth or a darkness to the album that it just doesn't have. I guess it has, but maybe production-wise it doesn't have. But yeah, so far the lyrics are definitely interesting. I'm getting along with that. Again, maybe this is going to just be an album of like hits and misses for me. Sorry to all the Kesha fans, but I'm definitely like, there are definitely some hits on here that I'm getting, like Something to Believe In, and Only Love Can Save Us Now, but we're only halfway through the album, so let's continue listening. In the next life I wanna come back, as a house cat, as a house cat. Up next life I wanna come, up next life I wanna come, as a house cat, as a house cat, as a house next life I wanna come, the next life I wanna come. Well, that was an outro that existed. Come back in the next life as a house cat with no drama, no problems. I'm not a cat person, so I would probably hate that existence. I don't know how to feel about that song. But up next, we have an interlude, so...
And you gotta allow that. That's still part of the grief reaction. And a lot of you are still holding on to grief from previous hurts. And then comes the time when you start to realize you'd rather be vulnerable and be hurt than be living dead.
Well, that was an interlude. No lyrics, but definitely a lot of words there. It's interesting her incorporation of this like old Hollywood, like I'm getting Twilight Zone narrator vibes into her songs. I don't know what the thought process was behind that, but it's definitely an interesting choice. But up next we have like a series of short songs starting with track 9, Too Far Gone. So she did start with that like old Hollywood recording there, so definitely a vibe we're carrying on.
Love comes with pain, I don't know why.
Ooh.
My whole life, too far gone.
Okay, so she's adding this little reverb on the end of her sentences. These lyrics though, I will say something about this album. These lyrics are definitely giving you a gut punch. The whole concept of too far gone, I'm not missing you, am I missing me? The whole, like, what piece am I missing? Okay, the lyrics. I need to, like, pull up Genius and figure out what the hell's happening. But you know I won't do that in this video. Okay, the lyrics are, am I missing you or am I missing pieces of me? Lyrically, this song has me. I think I need to listen to it again to see how I vibe with the production. She definitely has a lot more slower songs. A lot more slower. The grammar there was not proper. But she has a lot slower songs on this album than I was expecting. I mean, I guess maybe the first singles probably should have indicated that. But then Only Love Can Save Us Now, which I keep talking about, gave me a different vibe. But up next, we have another short-ish song called Peace and Quiet. She's definitely using these vocal effects more in this album. What else did she use it on? I can't remember what else she used this on. But we did see like Taylor Swift with Midnights do more of these vocal effects. So I don't know if that's like a something that's going to be continuing on more or not.
If I said I could do peace and quiet.
The chaotic production of it all, and also the whole sentiment of like, I can't do peace and quiet, like, I think, you know, chaotic production goes with I can't be peaceful and quiet, I need the chaos. Definitely see those merging. I don't know, my brain is going 100 different miles trying to, like, keep up with what's going on. It's not necessarily annoying me. I'm definitely, like, this is an album that you gotta go back to and listen to again to see how it flows, see the messages that are going on. So I guess we'll see how things flow later, but so far I'm definitely intrigued by what I'm hearing right now. Thank you. And she ended on a shh, trying to quiet her own brain. The outro was cool, talking about how every day of the week I have a different, like, level of stable and mental stability. Definitely relatable lyrics when it comes to, like, can't do peace and quiet. This is a song that I have no idea. It's like Handstand from Miley Cyrus's album, Endless Summer Vacation. I just don't know. I just don't know how to feel. Granted, I ended up ranking Handstand last, but that's just because it was the outlier of the album. This is not an outlier on the album. But up next, we have a reprise, which is Only Love Reprise, so I guess we're going to get a little more of those Only Love Can Save Us Now vibes.
Can you feel it?
Remember when I said I was getting Twilight Zone? Well, that was Creepy Doll Talking Zone. And that was the Only Love Reprise. But up next, we have the song that everyone keeps recommending to me, Hate Me Harder. And this is the end of our short songs before we get to the album closer.
Congratulations. You caught me doing some dumb shit again. That's what I do.
Okay, is this gonna be like a bold little ballad number? Is that what we're getting? Interesting. We know my ballads and I are tricky things to get along with.
I got nothing left to prove. So if hate didn't me help to love yourself, do yours, baby, give me hell. Hate me harder, hate me harder.
Okay. No one can say that the lyrics on this album aren't just amazing. And just, I can feel the build and the production, and it's calling my name. But the whole scent of, like, I graduated from caring? Yes, that's what we all need to do. And if hate makes you feel better, then go ahead and hate on me. I don't care anymore. Because my teacher always put it, in order to hate someone, you have to care enough about them to hate them. So...
funny, you're spending all that time and energy wasting me. It's so flattering.
Well, I love the lyrics about how it's so flattering that you seem to want to spend so much time focused in on me and what I'm doing. Like, your hate is really showing how much you care about what it is that I do. And I'm just like, stray hair, babes. But yeah, I've always believed in that sentiment. It's like, it's so flattering how much you choose to care about all the things I do, whether it's in a negative or yeah. But yeah, interesting. Definitely think this is going to be near the top of the ranking.
Hey, me, you love me. You just keep on talking all about me.
Okay, that's definitely going near the top of the album. The whole ending of, like, your hate is more about you than it is about me, hun, because you're looking for something to, like, get y'all riled up, or look for something to fixate on to avoid what's going on in your life, and this has nothing to do with me. Okay, last track, track 13, Happy. I'm wondering, it's 4 minutes and 22 seconds, I'm wondering if this is going to be, like, a big ballady, like, in, like, talking about how she's happy now, or she's searching for happiness.
Sometimes you think you're doing the magic, and sometimes you realize the magic is doing you, and this was one of those moments.
And she brought in that Twilight Zone old Hollywood speaker. This one did not give me Twilight Zone. I don't know what show this is giving me, but it's giving me something.
It's nothing like I imagined it, but if I wasn't this strong, but if it all just went different, so many times I wish I wouldn't just listen. I wasn't ready for it all.
Okay, so we're looking back on past events, wondering how life would be if some things had been done differently or if she had been a different person. Whew. Definitely curious to see where she takes these lyrics. Ooh, misty eyes today. Those lyrics, because, you know, back then, just want to live out my wildest dreams, and right now, all I want to be is happy. Oh, how things happen in life when you find out the only thing in life you really wanted in the end was to be happy. Felt that one hard. Well, I wanted a different ending to that song. I still enjoyed it, but I definitely wanted like a big bridge at the end and like not have her just do the oohs and the ahs to sing us out there. But, you know, can't get everything you want. But that is the end of the album reaction, so let's hop into the ranking. It's probably been a few days now, and I've listened to the album a few times, and this is going to be my final or current ranking of the album. I have a feeling I know what my top four are going to be, probably Hate Me Harder, Happy, Only Love Can Save Us Now, and Something to Believe In, because the rest of the album is in that iffy stage of things, and we've got a lot of like interludes and reprises that are just there, and I don't usually rank those high. I usually put those last. But overall, the album, the lyrics just have me going, like, I love the lyricism. It's the production that has me confused on where I feel about this album. I don't know if it's going to be up there with all-time favorite albums of the year or all time, but I definitely feel the emotion that she put into the album, and I can't wait to see where her career goes from here, given all that she's gone through and put through into this album. But yeah, let me know what you thought of the album, what was your favorite song, and what would you like me to react to next.